Hello everybody, welcome back to the channel. This is your captain, Bill Bosporus, and in this Explain 11 tutorial, I'm going to show you how to land an aircraft when both engines are failed. So it is really important that after both engines are failed, we need electrical power on board. And the second thing is that we're going to turn back to the nearest airport where we can land the aircraft safely. So you have to do this very fast because we need electrical power, and then after that we're gonna normally you're flying at a higher altitude at maybe example 30,000 or maybe 40,000 feet, and then after engine failure you have to circle around the airport after reaching 5,000 feet AGL. So that's what we're gonna do in this tutorial. We're gonna set the auto throttle off. We're gonna set it off, and then idles to the throttles to idle position, and then we're gonna looking for the airport, and in this case Istanbul Airport in front of us. We have planned that, so we're gonna turn off the autopilot. And then we fly directly to the airport, and keep an eye on your speed on the primary flight display. Keep the speed on 190 at least, and as you can see our altitude is 6,800 feet AGL. We have to fly above the airport until reaching 5,000 feet, and then after reaching 5,000 feet we're gonna make the turn to the downwind leg, because we're gonna start the landing on the runway. It is really important that we're gonna drop down our speed to 190. So in this case we lost our engines, we don't have power. We're gonna turn on the APU. We have to wait 1 minute to get the electrical power. So always keep an eye on the primary flight display and your speed at 190, and watch your speed at 5,000 feet. We're gonna turn back to the downwind leg. As you can see, the airport is below us. We're gonna make we're gonna circle around the airport, and that's what you have to do in all cases. When you fly higher altitude, you reach your airport, and then if you're flying too high, just circle around the airport until reaching 5,000 feet AGL, and then after that we are entering the downwind leg for basic and then final, and then go for the landing. Right, we decided that we're gonna land the aircraft on runway 17. Just make the turn until reaching 190. Let's have a look at the APU, the generator. We turned it on. So actually you've got power on, electrical power on your aircraft, and in the meantime we setting our auto brake to maximum because we need maximum brake at the landing. So I suggest that we gonna fly straight. We are at 5,500 feet. It's not a problem, because if you gonna make now a circle to the left, we gonna stay below the 5,000 feet, and that's too much. So we're gonna fly in the downwind leg, and our speed is 190. We're gonna use flaps 1. We are preparing for the landing, and at this altitude it is possible to reach the runway. I have tried it several times. This is a great tutorial on how to land an aircraft when both engines failed. A great tutorial with Explain 11. I hope you can do this challenge. Just try it on, and you will land the aircraft safely, and I'll save all the passengers. Right, there it is. Nose down a little bit to increase the speed to 190. There's the threshold of the runway. At this stage we have to stay with speed 190. There it is. And then go not too far, because if you go too far you can reach the runway. But also not too close turn. If you make too close turn, you can fly too high, and then you have to use too much spoilers to get lower. Okay, now we're gonna turn to left, the base leg, and in this leg we're gonna lower the gear, use flap 5, keep constantly your speed at 190. Gonna make the turn. This is the base turn. As you can see, our aircraft is trying to keep the speed at 190. There's the runway, so we're gonna turn a little bit to the left. Our altitude is 3200 AGL. Speed at 190. Let's have a look if we need some spoilers. I think we're gonna use a little bit spoilers. At final turn, we're gonna use flaps 50. So two times we're gonna click the flaps until reaching the flaps 15. There it is. We're gonna use runway 17 left, so we're gonna make the turn. Let's start it now. It looks great. Everything as scheduled. So we're gonna use flap 15. Two times click. All situation is different, so you have to make sure you're always looking to the runway. We're gonna use spoilers fully down because we don't we need this because we are a little bit too high and too fast, but that's not a problem. Okay, nose down, nose down, nose down, and line up with the runway. Nose up. Right. And at the last moment we can down and detent spoilers now, and then use flaps 30, and then flare at the last moment. And you will see that when after touchdown the aircraft, spoilers and the auto brake will do its work. It doesn't matter if you make a hard landing because you have to stop the aircraft at the end of the runway. So that's great. Alright, good job. We did it. Alright, let's have a look from the outside and let's talk about what we do exactly. Alright, this is the moment that we're gonna lose our both engines. Look at that. Both engines lost. And we're looking around to an airport, nearest airport, in this case Istanbul New Airport, at 7,000 feet. And we are flying directly to this airport. And in the meantime, we're starting our APU within 1 minute, the generators. And keep an eye on the primary flight display, speed at least 190 knots and until reaching of an altitude of 5000 feet AGL above the airport. It doesn't matter if you fly higher because you have to fly directly to the airport, and if you fly high then you have to circle around the airport until reaching 5000 feet. And after 5,000 feet, we're gonna entering the downwind leg, and in the meantime, you have to make sure you have choose some runway to land. And in this case, we have choose for runway 17 at the airport. This situation was really hard because of the weather. Also, normally, if we have a sky clear, we can make really easy decisions. But in this situation, it makes it a little bit harder. But look at that, we are below the clouds and we can see the runway and the airport. Everything is visible. Not now, but okay, there it is. And at this point, we don't need to circle because we've flown at this point at 5,500 feet, and we decided that we fly into the downwind leg and then make the landing. As you can see, aircraft is turning. We're always trying to keep our speed at 190, and always looking to the altitude of 5,000 feet AGL. So this is a really great X-Plane 11 tutorial. You can always use this tutorial for how to land the aircraft when both engines are failed. You can use this also to make a challenge for yourself, but also when you're in a flight and you lose both engines, then you can use this trick. It's really great. It worked for me always. I never had a great problem for this. But you have to do it exactly. Once you do that, everything will work fine. Okay, so your aircraft is still flying on a downwind leg, and in this stage, we will use flaps 1, right, and also keep your speed at 190. Still descending, looking always to the landing runway. We have choose runway 17. In this case, I can see the runway, and after passing the threshold of the runway, go a little bit straight on the downwind leg. Don't make immediately a turn to the left, because if you do that, the runway, landing runway, will you will make it short for yourself. So what I mean is that you have to go further on the downwind, on the downwind leg, past the threshold for maximum about 30 seconds. You know, as you can see in this replay, you can see that we are flying a little bit out of downwind, but it doesn't matter. We come close to the runway, and there you see we're gonna make the base turn, and in the meantime we are lowering the gear and flaps to 5. Oops, look at that, the nose gear has failed. Look at that. I don't know why it failed, but we did a great work, landed safely on the runway. And make sure you're turning on your emergency brakes before the landing. As you can see, we are using flaps 15 on the final turn. Look at that, I'm looking now to the left of the window, to the runway, if you are too high or too low. No, in the case of that you are flying too high, you have to use spoilers fully and then rapidly descend. And if you fly too low, don't use your spoilers, okay? This is the final turn, look at that. And at this stage we are using flaps 15. And I saw that we are flown too high. So we're gonna use our flaps and descending rapidly until the beginning of the runway. Just try that if you can't do that. But if you fly straight until the middle of the runway, it's not a problem, but you make it yourself difficult. As you can see, we are descending rapidly and then lining up with the runway. Look at that, nose up a little bit, because at the last moment we have to flare, and at the last moment we are gonna spoilers down and detent and using flaps 30 immediately. As you can see, the aircraft is hanging a little bit on the runway, but if you make a hard landing, no problem, just land the aircraft. In this case with nose down, not a problem. The emergency brake will do his work. As you can see, we will stop before end of the runway. Look at that, what a great stop. Alright guys, thanks for watching this X-Plane 11 tutorial. I hope this how to land an aircraft when both engines failed tutorial will work for you. Just subscribe on the channel if you see one more videos like this, and just thumbs up for this video if this video helped you, and just leave a comment. Thank you very much for watching this video, and see you next time guys.